We're just at the country store. Getting a morning coffee. And trying to decide which kind of pastry we want.
Lawrence,
this is Scott. This guy does a vintage Porsches.
Vintage Porsches?
Vintage Porsches.
What's your name?
Art.
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 Art. And where can people find you? Seriously.
How can people find me?
Vintage Porsches in LA.
Well, it would be my boss's shop, Emery Motorsports.
Emery Motorsports, check it out. And this is Art. See you later.
Okay, so we're back at the house and we're just getting set up for Nick West's coming, so she's going to be doing the interview here. And I've got the P-Bass out. I've got the P-Bass out because I had a few too many beers last night and ended up transcribing till like 5 in the morning, so it was worth it. Found some cool stuff. Who have we got this afternoon? And then who? And then we've got Tanya coming, Tanya O'Callaghan, Leprechaun, as she likes to call herself, coming this afternoon. So it should be a really cool day.
We're talking about
Vaseline
on the streets.
Yeah. Dangerous. Dangerous. Honestly, yeah, we're talking about Vaseline. Yeah. Everybody, whoa, there you are. We just finished up. We're just having a massive Pinot fest, aren't we?
Yes.
We're just all geeking out on Pinot.
And I have to do homework because apparently, I know Pinot from D'Angelo on. But they're telling me that I need to know people prior.
She didn't know about the fretless thing, so she's gonna be.
There's so much to learn, so I can't get through all of it, but I love Pino, so I'm doing homework.
Guys, what do you think's better, my hair or Nick's hair? And now I want you to leave comments about this, my hair or Nick's hair? Like, personally, I think I'm looking good. Packing up the gear and heading off to the airport. Tanya's gone home, Nick's gone home. We're about to go home.
Until tomorrow, I'll just...
Okay. Look, come in here. Say hello.
Hi, how are you?
We're on our way home and Ignacio is... Ignacio?
Ignacio.
Ignacio is going to bring us some good food.
Yeah.
Hey guys, it's on the plane, just had a killer sleep. Just slept all the way. Like 7 hours or something like that, which is really great for me. Normally I'm not a sleeper. That's Denmark. But yeah, we're just flying over Ireland now and then we'll be going down to Heathrow, so the trip is almost over. We're actually just discussing some cool plans for the live event that we'll be doing in the States next year, so some cool ideas coming about. We've been shown around the plane. We made a friend. Check it out. I want these huge double deckers. Oh, huge toilet. Cheers, guys. Say bye.
Bye.
Hey guys, so sorry for the lack of footage for that last bit. I was so tired, my brain wasn't working properly. I've just got home. This is my kitchen. You can see it's full of baby stuff. Baby bouncer. What else we got? Baby thing, whatever that is. Cars. This is my son's favourite toy. In all honesty, we've bought about, I think we're on our seventh one because he keeps breaking them. You know, it's electric, but he's not old enough to understand that you can't really push a car when it's like battery powered. So he puts the battery on, he gets so excited, he starts pushing it like crazy. And he breaks the car. So we're on our seventh one. And that's just the seventh white one. Like in fairness, I think we've probably had about five red ones as well. I've probably got shares in this company by now. So I've just got home. It's super, super late. Everybody's in bed. Even the dog is sleeping in the other room. It's 11:30. What an amazing trip. So first of all, I just want to say thank you for following me along this crazy, crazy journey. Let me just sit down. Oh, my achy bones. Yeah, just like, thanks for following me along this crazy... This crazy idea. What a crazy idea, eh? I'm glad we did it, man. I'm glad we did it. I think it's going to be a really exciting thing to be involved in, you know. And I love all the guys that we obviously got to meet along the way. It's taken a load of planning, but it worked out, you know. The day we got there, we had pretty much everybody reschedule on us. So it's been a little bit like playing chess. You know, we've had to do a lot of forward thinking to make it actually happen. But we got everybody, you know. I think we've come back with 12 interviews. So 6 days, 12 interviews. I'm pretty happy with that. And we've got a lot of like behind the scene footage as well. So that's going to be really cool. So this audio, this podcast, guys, I suppose a lot of you will be thinking, well, when's the podcast starting, right? When are you going to hear some of these interviews? Because some of them are really long as well. Like we got into the interviews and had some great chats. And they range in length from about 30 to 40 minutes right through to an hour and a half, which I'm really excited about because I really wanted to get those long form ones as well. So I can really find out about people's lives and their backgrounds and how they got into the bass and what did they practice when they were coming up and how did they feel about, you know, the pressures that were put on them by, you know, different bands or, you know, getting sacked. And, you know, there's really great conversations and some great stories in there. So I'm really looking forward to sharing all this with you guys. So the podcast will be getting launched, fingers crossed, in 2 weeks, if not three, like three absolute tops, but two, I'm aiming for 2 weeks. The only thing that might hold us back 1 week is that next week I'm recording a full blues course for the academy, and it's not my normal thing. I'm getting a whole band in the studio. We've got guitar, drums, you know, I'm going to be with the whiteboard. So it's going to be a really epic course. So I'm going to be recording that course next week. And just, the way these things roll is that next week might be swallowed. So I'm hopefully the podcast will be out in 2 weeks, if not 3 weeks. So, you know, keep a look out for it. And again, thanks so much for coming and taking part in this, you know, this adventure that we've all been on. Because it's been great looking at all the comments that people have been putting. And just knowing the same people have been tuning in every day. Let me know what you think about this style of content as well. I'm quite interested to know what you think about it. I could do this thing once a week, you know. Don't think I'd want to do it once a day as well as, like, you know, all the lessons and running the academy and managing the academy team and and all the rest of it. But yeah, I could maybe manage one a week. But let me know what you think about this vlog style video, because I've really enjoyed putting them together. It's been really good. I'm sure there's something else I want to tell you as well. So I've told you in the podcasts are coming out 2 to 3 weeks. I've said a big thanks. Keep an eye out for the big live event happening next year. That's really lofty, actually. It's a lofty idea. It's really lofty. I'm not going to really talk much about it next year. Essentially, if you missed it, over the last couple of vlogs, I've been talking about putting on a live event, probably in LA. A lot of the guys that have been interviewed would be involved in it. Essentially, I'd be teaching and doing workshops during the mornings and the days, well, the mornings through to the early afternoons, and then in the later afternoon we'd have guests coming in to do guest lectures. A lot of those guys would be the guys that I've interviewed over the past few weeks, if not all of the guys that I've they're all up for it, you know. I'm really, really pleased. I spoke to all of them about it and everybody seemed really excited about it, so all of the tutors will be involved as well. And the facility that we're looking at hiring is epic, you know, like it's, I'm not going to tell you what it is because I don't want to put my head on the line if we can't get it. But we've been told we can get it, it just depends whether we can get it in budget or not. It's one of the most iconic studios in LA. And essentially we've been talking about taking the entire facility, so hiring the entire place so we can... You know, because I want it to be immersive and I want it to be really everybody in, you know, in it. I don't want any distractions, so I thought it'd be a great place to hire. And it could probably fit, I don't know. There's obviously going to be a limited number on this as well. It's going to be 5 days long, purely educational based, starting probably like 9:30 in the morning, running through to the evening, and then performances at the evening. It's probably going to be, well, I'm not sure about the days yet, but it will be 5 days long. And we've even talked to Justin at the Baked Potato as well about hiring out the entire Baked Potato for the last day. So we can have all the tutors come down, all the students come down and perform. We've also talked to one of the most recorded drummers in history. I'm not going to tell you who it is because I just want to get it all finalized first. But he said he'd be really up for coming down on the last day and recording with all the students as well. And we're obviously going to film that, so every one of the students gets to play like a tune of their choice with this drummer, and we'll tune and then, you know. So obviously, this isn't going to be for hundreds of people, right? It's going to be for a real, you know, a limited amount of people. I'm just trying to figure out what that's going to be in terms of the budget and things like that, because I need to make it obviously work and come in on, you know, not lose money putting it on, you know, make it work. So I'll keep everybody posted on that. I'm sure I've got something else to tell you. I'll stop recording. I'll remember it. But anyway, even if I don't, thanks again, guys, for coming and checking out these weekly vlogs or these daily vlogs. Let me know if you like the content like this. You know, I could maybe do something like this once a week. It could be quite fun. I enjoy it. And, you know, and just keying back into what I said in yesterday's vlog, at the end of yesterday's vlog, guys, make sure you're creating something all the time. You know, don't wait for that door to knock. If you're trying to get your bass playing to the next level, you know, you got to make it happen yourself. You can't wait for somebody to come and knock on the door and give you that opportunity. You know, you got to make the opportunity yourself. So that could be starting a band. Okay, maybe if you want to play in a band, maybe it's up to you to start that band. It could be studying with somebody really great. You know, all of the guys that I've spoken to throughout this, all the 12 guys that I've... Obviously, when I say guys, I mean girls as well, right? So the guys that I've spoken to of these last 12 interviews, every single one of them has studied, you know. None of them I just got good. You know, all of them have studied. You know, Ricky Miner had a mentor. You know, Chris Chaney had a mentor. He went to Berkeley. Sean Hurley went to Berkeley, you know. Tanya Callaghan, I was speaking to yesterday, she went to a music school in Ireland. You know, all these guys sort of like studied with people. So if you really want to push your playing to the next level, it's time to, you know, get up and get on with it and stop thinking about it, because you'll think it away and you'll be sat in the same situation as you are next year with the same skill level. So all you need to do is get up and get on with it. And then when next year comes, if you've, you know, if you dig in and do it, well, then next year you'll be able to think back at this point and think, wow, you know, I've really made a lot of progress in the last 12 months. So I really urge you to do that, because you can make a huge difference to your playing. Just study the right stuff. Study the right stuff. It's not hard. You know, actually doing it is tricky, you know, because, you know, it takes stamina. It takes, you know, perseverance. And, you know, and sometimes you'll feel like, you know, you'll have self-doubt, as all musicians do. But actually doing it, you just got to get up and do it. Just do it, you know. So anyway, thanks again, guys, for checking out. I'm keeping my voice down, by the way. I don't want to wake up the kids upstairs and the wife. You know, I can't believe I've got kids. God, I still feel like I'm like 17 or something. No, don't really. But anyway, take it easy, guys. Bye.